When a test comes, and that sin spirit tells you, you need to fix this.
Yeah.
Wow.
You're a fool. You gonna let that happen? You ain't tired of this? Anybody here with me?
Yeah.
Yes.
Chanda! Baroshake! Do I have anybody here who understand?
Amen.
That God just wants you to rest?
Yeah.
Read the last verse I'm gonna read. Just, you need to hear this, then I'm done.
Neither is there any creature that is not manifest in his sight. But all things are naked and open unto the eyes of him with whom we have to do.
Hold it. Now here's what I'm going to help you with. When you think it just happened because the devil got mad, he just said nothing is hidden from the sight of the word. Y'all ain't talking. See, you think the bitch over there trying to fix you and trying to mess your life up? You think they just plan to do that and God don't know about it. But all things are open.
That's right.
Yes.
Y'all been talking about it. See, if you get this, it's going to help you. If you understand that no matter what happens, he sees it.
That's right.
And it's under his control.
Yes.
He has absolute control over the witches who are trying to fix you.
Yes.
Amen.
Come on.
And whatever he allowed them to do, he allowed them to do it so he can show them who he is in your life.
Amen.
He told Moses, I raised up Pharaoh to rebel against you and to resist you, so I can show my power in him.
Yes.
Are you all here with me?
Yes.
All things are open and naked under the eyes of him that all we have to do.
Yes.
So ain't nothing they're doing that God can know about.
Yes.
And since you're an eternal plan, he already fixed it for you.
Yes, God.
Thank you, Lord.
Let me read you something. I will hit and be done. The rest of God for us today is the promise he makes to us. The promises are only announcements of the works that are already finished in the finished work of God. To enter into that rest, we must stop trying to do things our way. After we are saved, if we want to enter rest, we must stop doing things the way we used to do them. We have to stop depending on our intellect and ability. We have to cease from our own works. We have to work hard at trusting God. We have to work hard at believing in his integrity and authority. We have to work to trust his predestined plan no matter what we see, feel, smell, or think. We have to stop reacting to any and every stimulus based on our own understanding or in our own wisdom or strength. We must know that the promise of God is his word, and he is his word. He will perform what he declares. And the question then becomes, whose report do you believe? It's going to intensify the more you go up in them. The devil's going to get tricky, and they're going to get in your mind. And when God is processing you to something, that's why Paul said, casting down imaginations.
Yes.
You have to know this. You have to know how to respond with what God told you. No matter how you feel, no matter what it looks like, no matter what the enemy tried to convince you of, you have to know what your promise is, and you have to say, I still believe God. And you have to say, I'm still God's prophet to the nations of the world.
Yes.
You're already talking back
to
me. Just give me 5 minutes. I'm going to share my life with you. Amen. You have to tell yourself, I'm still God's prophet to the nations of the world.
Yes.
I'm still sanctified today in the mouthpiece and showpiece for God. Mm-hmm. It looks bad. It looks like somebody tripping. Everything looks like it's going wrong. It looks like it can't happen. But that's walking by sight.
Yeah,
that's
right,
saying it on the thing. You have to know this, y'all. If everybody just stops shouting here, I want you to feed you my heart. You have to know that the promise, you gotta believe it. And no matter what you see, feel, or think, if you're gonna grow in Christ and get there, you have to speak that which God said.
Yes.
So whatever God said to you, I don't care how blind you get, do not complain.
Yes.
Don't speak what the devil wants you to speak. Yes, you feel like it. But if you're gonna grow and rest, you gotta rest in what God said.
Yes.
I am a prophet to the nations of the world.
Yes.
I am sanctified with the name of and show me for God. Fran and I, we have a modern marriage, and we shall maybe our modern family.
Yes.
We are millionaires in this world. We have a family, and we will never have need of anything. Don't talk about it. I don't care what the devil taught me. I tell you, my wife will be a witness to Jesus. I say this every day, numerous times a day. You know why? That's his promise.
Yes.
So I don't care what I see right now. I live in that promise. Don't talk about it. And we got to be people that recognize that the enemy's attacking because we got to live in that promise. So no matter what I think about saying to her, I'm going to say what God said about the situation.
Yes.
That's why people can't talk, I can't complain about her, because I don't see, say what God said you ought to talk about.
Yeah, that's true, Apostle.
Hallelujah. So you gotta go to the point where you're gonna rest in what God said. If God says that you have a business, that's your business.
Yeah.
Yes. Things got slow, but that's your business. Yes. If God said that business is prosperous, it's prosperous.
Yes.
So no matter what happened, you gotta say, this business is prosperous.
Yes, God. Yes, God.
Oh, God, help me. Yes. You gotta say it out of your mouth. And I'm talking because I want you to grow. This ain't no emotional stuff. You gotta say it when you don't think it.
Yes.
Because that enemy will get in your mind and control your thinking.
Oh, yes.
And ain't nothing you can do about it. That's just the way it is.
Yes.
And you'll have you convinced that you've lost.
Uh-huh.
But you gotta open your mouth and say, I'm resting in this promise.
Yes, God. Yes, God.
General Love International Family Ministries is a worldwide ministry of signs and wonders and miracles. We are one church in many locations. I'm a pastor of many pastors. Can I stop and talk to you?
Yes.
There are about 7 pastors right now who asked me to be their pastor. Now watch this. I've been saying this for 20 years.
Yes.
Yes.
Mama Pastor.
I heard it look like it, it don't look like it, I still kept saying it.
Yes, yes, yes. Yes.
Glory to God. That's why when I declare I'm a millionaire, I've been saying that for 15 years. Don't be shocked when somebody comes and write me $1 million check. But you know what? I thank God every time I go before him for the 2 people he promised me was going to write me $1 million check.
Yes.
I don't have to know where they're coming from. I don't have to know. I don't care where they're coming from.
He'll work it out. He'll work it out.
I thank him for those 2 people who will write me a check. And just as now, 20 years later, men are coming to ask me to be the pastor. Some of them are coming at the appointed time, according to the time of life. Lord, they're talking to me. You write these checks for me? I hope I said it to you. So, you see, I'm going to reset on that one. There might be some of y'all write a check.
Amen.
And you saw what's sitting right in there. Because you don't know what tomorrow's going to bring.
That's true.
I feel Jesus.
That's true.
You should have some faith that he's talking about me.
I've been talking about me.
If the Lord promises you, you'll be a millionaire.
Amen.
You should stop thinking right now that you're the one who will write a check for your apostle. See, your partner got some faith. I'm going to be the one to write that check. I received that money right now. Don't do like most people now. Receive and forget. Someone's in there. So as I close, it is more
of a blessing.
As I close this, I want you to rest. It's a battle to rest. It is. It's the hardest thing you're going to do. Because everything about your life wants to fix it. You want to get straightened. Somebody hurts you, you want to get straightened. And you will wait till the time you can get them to get straightened. But what would happen if you just rested?
Yeah, that's true.
What would happen? If you just said, Lord, I heard that.
Yes.
I see that.
Yes.
But I trust your plan so much that I'm believing.
Yes.
I'm not going to respond to that.
Come on.
Because I know that came at your point in time on my life. So I know if that came, you have a plan for that. So I'm going to trust you in that. So I'm not going to respond to that. Whatever that's supposed to do in my life, it's going to do by the Spirit. But I trust you so much, I'm going to stay right here, focused on what you told me. I'm not going to be distracted by what they did or what they said. Y'all ain't talking back to me. But what came to the man, I believe you sent it. I'm going to give you glory. I thank you. I still believe what you told me. I know this is a part of your plan for me. I know you have a good plan to work this out.
Yes. I know.
Is anybody growing up here?
Yes.
Is anybody here willing to rest?
Yes.
It's not easy because you got to live with people. And people try you beyond measure.
Oh, yes.
You understand? But you got to know, that if they're in your life, they have a place there.
Yes.
I want y'all to walk with me. Put the church down. I want you to walk with me in kingdom. Anything in your life has been placed. There are no mistakes in grace. Because if you think somebody in your life a mistake, that means God made a mistake. That means that when God sat down and counseled with himself about his creation, he made a mistake. Or it means that somebody in the creation that he created has changed his plan. That's not possible. Neither one of them possible. So no matter what you run into, you don't have to like it. It's not a mistake. And you have to say to the Father, listen, I know you sent this person. And I will kill him right now, but I'm not going to respond. See, you can't deny the feeling that coming, the thought that coming, the point that coming. Yes, right? But if I can